There we go. No,
we can start with...
Hello. Hello! Hello, everybody!
Hello!
Hello, and welcome to RuneScape Developer Q&A.
That's us.
That is us. We're talking about Elf City Waterfall Fishing today, along with a little splash, of elite mobs and Halloween. A lot of important people have sat in this chair, but I get to do it today, so I'm hosting. So, and the other people in the stream are...
Mod Avatar.
Mod Raven, apparently the overloud.
Praise me!
Praise me.
Mod Timbo, Bane of Trees.
And Mod Wilson.
We're going to start with a traditional icebreaker, otherwise there'd be a riot. This time we want to involve you. So we want to know, what item would you want to be gold on next year's raffle?
Oh.
So obviously we've had, we've got the Barry's items that are gold in this year's September raffle. What would you guys like to be gold? Doesn't have to be an existing item. I'm going to break the ice with my teeth. I'd like to have some individual gold teeth on my chathead.
Okay.
Just putting that out there.
That's not bad.
golden goby.
Golden goby. We
can change about the golden
that
goby.
Fest, I guess.
Oh, the golden M's should be golden gobies.
Yeah, golden gobies.
They should be so heavy. try to lift them from the table.
Just to have sort of like them gold inscribed onto a lead ingot.
Yeah, that's yeah. It. And they'll truly deserve it if they manage to take it away. Mod Raven?
I'm going to go with the gold, the fluffy creatures from the gnome quest.
Sheep. Oh, the cute creatures.
The really yes. cute creatures. Yeah. I think
the illusion
gold
things,
one of those.
Aren't they? Yeah.
Spoilers.
Illusion from creatures. A 10-year-old quest.
I want a golden wig. Like, and Pie Pete.
Nice, gold throw.
Yeah, gold cool, throw, cool. Pretty cool.
I'm going to go for gold diving equipment, because nothing quite says opulence like being unable to breathe under the water.
Bouncing on the seabed in pure gold.
Help me.
Can't see.
Someone it's heavy suggested enough. Golden gold bars, I have to point
that
out.
Is oh, beautiful.
Gilded gold bars.
So the important thing here is we are going to gather together the best ones that we like. Got guys behind the scenes are checking the stream, and the ones that we really like are put at the end in a straw poll. So there we go, we'll get to that eventually. But obviously, talking about the September raffle, just going to talk about kind of how are people using their tickets, do you think? So what I'm going to do here is kind of a higher lower. So if you add two tickets to each day, what is the chance of me getting 100 million coins? So guys.
Is this a trick question?
Percentage chance. What is the chance of me getting 100 million coins if I contributed two tickets to the 100 million coin
day? It's worse for me because I'm a balancer. Like, this is my job.
Yeah, we're going to win.
You said higher, lower. This isn't higher or lower.
Yeah,
the question.
Of higher, lower. Yeah. You know Bruce Forsyth.
So start me off with a number. Go on, Mod Raven, give me a number. What percentage
no?
chance?
Oh, 3.
You're playing my game. 0.3%. So higher or lower than 3% chance of getting 100 mil if you put in two tickets.
Lower.
It's indeed lower. Yes. It's 0.3%.
Okay, close. So we're not going to have a go then, are
no.
we?
No.
I've got loads to
that
get through.
Didn't work.
I've got so many to get through. Large protein packs. What do you reckon? 2%?
Higher.
Higher than that.
Lower.
How much higher? It's 95%. You're correct. It is higher.
95%.
So, Death Touch Darts. 3 Death Touch Darts. What's the chance of me getting it?
Lower?
Lower than 95.
It's 30%. So if you give two tickets, you've got a kind of effectively a 1 in 3 chance getting 3 Death Touch Darts. Spring Cleaner.
Lower.
Lower.
Lower, 12%. And then Golden Barrow Sets.
Lower.
Lower.
5%? You're good at this game. Yes. Like we just made up and winged.
Next week on Higher or Low. Mod Osborne.
I didn't see a problem with this. It's perfect. Worked well. So obviously we're here for waterfall fishing. I think should we get the big question out of the way? When is it out?
Week beginning the 21st.
We don't know. No,
we do know. So it's said. Yes. We have literally just said. But Jesus spoke over us, so obviously
okay,
Jesus.
Right. Apparently,
Jesus
we don't know anymore.
Anyone. It's, so we're saying 21st. So it's not next week, which is vampires.
Vampires. That's right.
But after that.
Yep.
How's we get onto some waterfall fishing.
That's right.
Okay. So can you give me like a very quick summary of what waterfall fishing is?
Well, basically, it's Elf City. There's a waterfall in it, and once you grapple up to the top there, and it was a suggestion by one of the people that we've got in the Twitch at the moment.
Yeah.
And you can.
Because you don't have to grapple up, can you?
Well, you can make a shortcut as you can with all of the other grapples, but you get up there, and there's low, medium, and high level spots where you can fish up these crystal urchins, and it's really good experience.
What kind of levels? What fishing levels are you looking at?
It's 93, 95, and 97.
Yeah, so you're going to show us through that in a moment, but we'll just answer some of the feed's questions, some that are on the forums.
You require high level agility to get up there as well.
Yes, that's for the grapple section.
Okay, so one of the big questions that was asked was from Baku. I think you've got to say it in a yak way. Baku. Mm-hmm. Baku. Will waterfall fishing be worth it, considering the fast XP rates you can get with both Crystallize and the Fury Shark outfit?
Yes.
So have we made it worthwhile?
Yeah, we have.
We've been doing it today, haven't we?
Yeah,
we just
finalised the experience rates.
Rolling
today.
That dice.
So, it's better than Crystallize. Yeah. Crystallize is, someone's going to correct me, but I think it's 130 to 145k right now. Crystallize fishing with all the boosts will be about 190k an hour. That might scare some people in the chat. I can't wait for the reaction.
But we're talking like top end.
We're talking with an aura, with a familiar, with some of the new things from fishing that I don't want to talk about yet.
We'll reveal on stream.
We're definitely aware that it needs to be worth it.
Yeah, but you're not getting any product. You're still going to have a reason to go to Rock
Tower. Well, you still get the urchins, which can be used for buying stuff in the shop and a few other things. But you're not getting food product.
Yeah.
there's the chat, GG.
So from the chat, we've got a question from Eric at Eridin. So does it include POH Aquarium? Does the update include aquarium content?
No, not at the moment.
No, we want to in the future. There's some limits.
Technical weirdness that we were looking at dealing with.
Yeah, we haven't solved it yet.
Yeah, I literally went to the aquarium guys to find the documentation on how to add stuff, and they were like, not just yet. I'm going to back off with it there.
So sorry about that, guys, not yet. Will the voice of Seren affect crystal fishing?
No.
So, because of course, when we were doing the voice of Seren, the skill focuses for each of them.
The problem is it doesn't fit any of the clans. We tried to shoehorn it into, I forget which clan, but we're arguing over them.
It's basically a fishing agility clan.
They like animals.
We tried to
in the nicest way.
But ultimately it's like, we could shoehorn it in, but it's already good rates.
Where does it sit, the waterfall?
It's between
northeast, isn't it?
Two clans that just don't work with it.
Okay. Answers one of my other questions. A question from Dave Biglife, which is my tube. So this has come from me. Where is all that water coming from?
I see, we pitched this as a suggestion to get the players to tell us, because so far our answer has been magic, or alternatively, an underground, very pressurised spring.
A wizard did it.
When I pop into home base, they've got little rocks that can do water all the way around for about a tenner.
Hence the very pressurised spring.
Yeah. That's home base, everybody.
You're comparing the Elf City to home base.
So basically, if you go under Elf City, there's just like all of these pipes and stuff going under there.
So was that product placement? Like next week, we're going to just have like a big box of those rocks on here.
I'll pull some strings.
This week's
stream is
sponsored by Homebase.
so we're asking the feed to go for it. I my favourite from the feed so far is Mod Jesus did it. I like that constantly you're just going, oh, go on, keep cycling.
It would be a waterfall of wine.
A waterfall of wine,
however.
That's true.
Yeah.
So.
Well, maybe we can get that change in. It could be white wine. Brilliant.
Blue wine.
Are there any comp or trim racks?
No, we decided not to for this because some people have complained about like having to go and do absolutely everything.
It's like having Comprex on Seren Stones or
Chicken Island. Yeah, exactly.
There's not many completionist aspects.
It's got more to it than that.
Yeah, sort of like it would be like fish once from each of the things, fish 100 urchins from each of the things. It just wasn't worth it. Yeah.
Okay, here's a heavy question, but perfectly valid. It's Mamskip. Okay, so the idea on Rune Labs was to put it in the Elf City. But why did we do so? Because Prothinus is overstuffed with content. What made you not move the location somewhere more suitable?
Well, primarily because it was a RuneLab suggestion.
Aside from that, I think that's what she's going for.
We're looking at like the highest level in the, sort of like highest level, quite AFK training sort of like area. I mean, we could have come up with a completely new area or something like that. But I mean, unless we tagged it onto like an existing fishing area is just a really hard, like maybe a fishing guild waterfall.
One of the toughest things I've found is that so many people voted on the idea probably because it was in the Elf City. As soon as you start changing that, there's a
problem. Then it's the core idea that's been changed.
One of the things, I mean, is Elf City kind of curator, half curator thing me? Because it was such high level content, it didn't quite impact on, you know, it only comes in right at that top end.
I was about to say there's quest requirements to get into the city.
Yeah.
Like huge quest requirements that allow us to make it as good.
Similar to thieving in the way that Elf City deals with thieving.
Yeah. Mm. Top end, mining.
Not actually one that the clan focuses.
Yeah.
Yeah. Cool. All right. Are we only receiving fishing XP from the waterfall?
There's token agility XP for some of the little things that you have to hop over to get up and down, because they are just very quick little rocks you jump over. There is a bit of strength XP from one of the random events, which we may see, we may not. I think there's a little bit of extra agility for one of the other ones. So it's not purely fishing XP, but it is mostly fishing XP at a good rate.
Yeah. if you've got an update called Elf City Waterfall Fishing, you probably expect a decent proportion to be fishing.
Yeah.
Will we ever see different types of fishing rods? Now, I took this out from another section because really it kind of affects what we've got in Waterfall Fishing, because we've got a new fishing rod. Mm-hmm. I think. Can we mention?
Yes, that's one of the
Oz bomb.
That's one of the extras I'm going to be showing. Sort of like, as was mentioned earlier, things that will increase the rate of fishing. There is going to be a crystal fishing rod, and you're going to be able to unlock the ability to get that made on the crystal tool seed, and that increases your ability to catch any fish that require a rod to catch.
Oh, sweetness.
So yeah, so I don't know about, you know, having like bronze, iron, steel, dragon rods and the rest of it, having a grandmaster quest to go and unlock the legendary dragon one, but
I know that Invention, for example, is looking at fishing rods or things that can augment fishing rods.
So it could be.
There's a good old skill chompers. They have level requirement.
Oh, look at that, plugging your skill chompers.
Plugging my content. Please use skill chompers. And of course, please use
them. And of course, there's the Barrows fishing rod, which nobody has found yet.
Kappa, kappa, kappa. Kappa. All right, so the last question on it from Errol to any new songs coming with the update. They love their songs. Errolton loves the songs.
No, unfortunately. It's effectively a small extension onto the Elf City area, so we weren't going to get an extra song for that, unfortunately.
Well, so we'll stop the talking, about waterfall fishing anyway, and get you onto the computers. And in the meantime, we'll talk about something else that happened. Wait, it conveniently happens to be the anniversary.
Yes.
The anniversary of the Elf City at the same time.
What, is it the exact day?
It's not the exact day, but it's the same week.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, you may see some things popping up as a kind of celebration of the year anniversary of Elf City. Can't believe it's a year.
I know.
No, it's kind of.
Think about how much time I've spent in the Elf City, just moving from Serenstone to
just
Serenstone.
Just AFKing.
Another load mooring.
And it's been there.
There are people still there.
It's a year since it's been out. So it's been
the first
like,
batch.
It's been like, what, 2 years since I've touched it? It was starting with Elf City. Yeah. It's like,
just think about it. There are people still who haven't left the Elf City for an entire year. Still AFKing. Random things.
Love it. But it's such a beautiful place, and of course you can't dismiss a lot of the content that's in there. But I think just to talk about it for a little bit, what could have been in there? We obviously talked about some things that we've left out.
There were loads of things.
I know that you wanted, because it was made of crystal, the city, you wanted all the light to catch it and burn elves.
I wanted lasers to burn the elves. I think it would have been fine. Players wanted weather effects. I thought a bright sunny day in Priftiness. Fire and brimstone and death. I thought it would have been beautiful.
We're also talking about the Traherne being completely dead. They were all automatons.
Remove them all and just have Lady Traherne and her robot minions.
There was a massive elf massacre just leaving things left. But there were other things. We sat together and you just went through a sheet of all the things I was proposing. And went, no.
Yeah, like the very first design document you ever made. And
it went to the players union.
Yeah, like me and Osborne sat in a room and I was like, no, yes, no, yes, no.
So it was even more open.
Like build your own Slayer dungeon.
Yep. Yeah, it was based on your current Slayer targets and preferences.
Yeah.
Crazy.
That was initially Rush of Blood, wasn't it, before got changed to Rush of Blood?
Because we knew that we wanted Slayer, which of course is quite hard to just put in a resource for. There's not really many resources for Slayer, so we thought...
Original thieving was fun.
There was a massive agility course all over the Elf City.
That's true.
All
the rooftops. Damn, yeah.
Grabbing light creatures, doing all these things, and just like the rest of it. Imagine the people doing the environments just crying when we mentioned that.
It was the original intention was it almost like an agility course crossed with Jack of all trades.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You go through and like do everything on that run. who knows, maybe we'll get that done at some point. But obviously in the design dog, there are a few other things like tower chimes that we really want to do, where everybody's playing a note on, one note on top of each tower, and you can hear the other towers.
So you could kind of, the idea was that they were, the community would get together and make music.
Yeah.
Or just hit, randomly hit just the same
thing. Or somebody would turn up and grief. Yeah, you know, just ruin somebody's expected. Perfectly made song with hitting D flat repeatedly. Yeah, there we go. So I believe we're ready over onto the computer. So over to Mod Tony.
Okay, so here we've got the base end of the waterfall. So you can see the little shop here. I'll just run up the way. So there's no requirements on these, so you can actually just come wandering along. Yeah, well, basically there's these little handholds that you go up to, then you've got the grapple point. There's a couple little graphical polish things that we've got to do. Oh, so it looks like one of the random events has gone off in the background, which is the geyser, which will deposit the urchins all over the landscape up here. We just must have just missed it, unfortunately. And then you can, oh, and you can just basically, oh. I think I might be about to jump down the cliff. Yep, there we go. trying to pick up the urchin and failed. So, just get back up there. and yes, once you're up here, we've got these little piers here, which you can go and fish the urchins from. Yeah, there's a couple of height map issues which are causing difficulty to run past squares. This is all getting polished up as we speak. I just didn't want to reboot at the moment. So yeah, then there you are. You just up there. You're fishing it here in this case at the low spot, and I'm grabbing away little urchins. Now, people will probably be taking a look at the XP there and going, "Oh my God, that's not the best XP ever." But this is I haven't plugged in those rates that. We were just talking about now that that's first thing tomorrow morning job, because we were just looking at the numbers before we came on here. But yeah, so we've got the low urchins there. Oh, got stuck again. There we go. Oh. Right. Try doing that, bypassing these. Then up here you've got the spot for the medium urchins, and over here you've got the ones for the highest level urchins, and then that's kind of where the area just ends. So yeah, these are going to be a bit close to the water, don't worry. But yeah, you just basically, you're here, you fish, you get your big urchins, you can grind them up for powder, which can be used in a juju fishing potion to make a perfect fishing potion, or you can equip the crystal fishing rod, which you can also, which stacks with the fishing potion to increase your catch chances. Oh, looks like that seems to have stopped disappearing off your back for the time being. And then, yep, yeah, you just keep catching away. And you have a low chance per catch to be able to catch a hermit crab pet, which is the new one, which I believe people have seen some concept art of this before. So there, we've got it there, and it will follow you around and plonk itself down like that. And what you can do with the hermit crab to customize it is you can give it different shells. I'm going to show just a couple of them now. There's like there's five in total. You'll be able to see some of them in the shop in a moment. But you've got this one, and you've got this one, and the big fancy shell.
That's so cool.
Yeah. Yep. He's got bandages on his claw there. That was a little touch from the concept art guys. I'll just scoot back down to the shop that everyone saw at the beginning there to show you a few of the other things that are around on that. Oh, yeah, looks like those are finally going. So there's three random events. The geyser, which I mentioned, which sprays urchins all over the different platforms so people can just go and grab them. There's the there's a giant urchin which beats itself near the fishing points, and multiple people can team up to pull it out of the water. And there's leaping urchins which fire up into the air, and you try and grab them quickly before they disappear. Now, again, the cost of things in the shop is also one of the things that we just discussed before we came on here. So we've got a couple of things that you can unlock, which is the ability to make the crystal rods yourself or get them crystal sung for you. And there's a new title, Master Fisherman or Master Fisherwoman. And yeah, here's the five hats that we've got there, the boot, chest, lump of coral, and then the two shells. And just so that this doesn't, you don't like get all of these items and then you're done, you can always go and catch urchins for fishing lamps for more fishing XP. Okay, I think that is. Also, the size of the crystal determine. This is going to be changed to crystal urchin points, because larger urchins are worth more in the shop than smaller ones. So yeah, there's like a little economy thing there. Cool. I think we. Yeah, that's basically about it there.
Thank you very much, Martoni.
No worries.
Cheers. So there are a couple of questions kind of recurring. I'm looking at you here, Mod Raven, while we transition to help us out. Do you know the agility requirement for waterfishing?
Tony?
Do it by sign.
90. At the moment.
90. There
90
you go.
At the moment. So that's what we're looking at. We may change that, or it's probably locked. Okay, so we're looking
pretty
at
happy
90.
With 90.
Yeah.
And we've just revealed that there is a title, or two titles, effectively, for waterfall mm-hmm. fishing. There's a lot of people in the feed wanting something else that we're not going to be able to give,
yeah,
I'm afraid.
Yeah, no, they can't have that one.
Marvellous. And it's worth mentioning that this was a Rune Labs idea, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah. So probably the most involved that any...
We've been chatting with Foranka Real, who's the person who suggested a reasonable amount. Well,
Forank
I say
one,
we.
One, one, one,
Modley
four,
and
4-7, wasn't it?
I don't know.
Foranko 147.
I believe he might be in the chat, so I'm sure.
Yeah.
Hi, Forank.
don't know what your name is, but hello.
Yeah, Modlian has been running design back and forth, so we've been keeping in contact.
Sweet. All right, so before we move on to some meaty questions, I'm calling them, which won't stick in anyway, and then elite mobs, I just wanted to mention that Modtoni has been here for 10 years, so are we. Congratulations.
Thank you, thank you.
And Modraven is now lead developer.
Yeah.
So you have a new title to add to your many other titles.
Yes.
He actually is an Overlower.
Of souls.
I am now an Overlower.
Amazing. All right, so some meaty questions for you to get your teeth into. So Autumn Elite has asked, so it's a bit of a long one. While I have no problem with the idea of elite skills, some of the ideas being discussed seem undeserving. Harsh. most benefits of sailing are already in game. And don't seem rich enough to deserve an entire skill. Will there be some form of player discussion and quality control to check elite skill ideas are worthy of being made?
I mean, I'm fairly sure we will talk to players about
anything
everything
like that. Will be
like we've been fairly upfront about invention, upfront about elite skills in general.
Mm-hmm. Yeah,
I think we're aiming to do a lot more of that anyway. I mean, we tried it with the Seren spells in prayers, just talking more with the players. I think there are a bunch of things that we don't do that we could do with sailing.
Yeah,
that
I think they're one of the things that I feel that RuneScape's missing is that sense of exploration.
Yeah. Yeah.
That feeling of I'm going somewhere that nobody else has been before, maybe even finding it before anybody else. I think you can do that. It won't necessarily just be a transport hub because God knows we've got enough of those.
Yeah.
I think it would be like ports plus, really.
Yeah. Yeah. I think
without the kind of AFK.
I think we'd have to sell sailing before anyone understands what our vision of it is.
Yeah.
Because like I know me and
Kelpie.
Kelpie
loves a bit of the sailing.
And Mod Prox? No, what's it? Mod Pips.
Yeah.
I mean, we've talked about sailing a lot.
Yes.
And
what it could offer.
Yeah, exactly.
And it wouldn't be interface driven like ports.
It would be interface driven.
There's cool stuff that we can
do.
Yeah.
And we've got some prototypes.
And it'd be different from old school as well. So.
Yeah. Yeah. Indeed. Okay. So, Champ Pokemon gave so many questions. It's unbelievable. So, I'm going to pluck a couple because it obviously deserves it. Are there any plans to create more raids in other areas, specifically Tarthiad, Infernus, and Abner? Scree.
Scree indeed.
Yeah. I think.
I'd like to.
Yeah, we've got the system. You know, we can make raids. You know.
It depends on use of them as well. Yeah. One of the things with raids is that they're all. If you go to other games, they're stacked behind each other.
Mm. Yeah, I think we'd like to sort of flesh out and finish off the raid that we've got on Mazcab before we really start sort of putting in lots of other raids all over the place. But I would imagine it's quite likely that we'll end up with raids elsewhere where they are.
Yeah.
who knows? I mean, who knows where we're going to be in the future and like what where it exactly. makes sense to go.
And it's hard to talk about these things before RuneScape.
No, I mean,
as well.
I mean, it might make sense to tie some raids to some quest lines or something later on down the line. And so, yes, raids will be coming to somewhere that isn't Mazcab at some point, but who knows when?
Sweet. And screaming at cupcakes. Who also asked several questions. And it's
that is a brilliant.
I thought that was like amazing. I thought that you just had like some sort of episode there, sort of like instead of and speaking of rays, you're like and screaming at cupcakes,
screaming with joy, or
I just like them just going ah and a cupcake.
Yeah.
Well, obviously we have to answer several of this person's questions so that I can repeat their name.
Right.
Walking into a bakery and just having a complete breakdown.
So congrats on that name. Did Damrock and Rhiannon meet? And if so, will they ever be expanded upon? So if people don't know, this is Shattered Heart Guy and Golden Shattered Heart Girl.
Yeah, we discussed this before because I got confused because I thought that some of this was already known, but it's
not. It's another thing that got trimmed.
Yeah, that we didn't actually put in the Elf City, but in my head, we're still there. So the two of them did meet and kind of had a bit of a rivalry.
Yeah.
And there was some weird magic revenge flinging, but both of them are kind of a bit naff.
So. Yeah, because Damrock has always like famously been a pacifist.
Yeah.
So you could probably guess what he cast, we had a story in place. We just don't know whether or not we're going to get to that story.
Yeah,
to be honest. It's one
sure
of those that
like,
I can feel. I can feel it like going past this. We may not do. But yeah, you could probably plug in the gaps a little. And screaming at cupcakes again. Will fire making ever be improved on or made worthwhile, even with ninja level updates?
Probably not.
Can we not have another?
Well, what's not worthwhile about setting fire to things?
Yeah, well, we had bonfires, didn't we? That kind of enlivened it a little bit. Is there anything else like that we could
do? Well, the bonfire, well, no, you don't need to have, there's the bonfires and the rest of it from Halloween. Yeah.
Let's turn this on its head and say, we have Rune Labs now. It's like, what would you want to do with fire making?
Yeah.
What suggestions do you have
for making
arsonists fire making?
Yes, and pyromaniacs. What can you imagine doing?
I've always thought it would be awesome to have like some sort of fireworks crafting based on fire making or something.
Yeah, I like the idea of setting fire to like other businesses to improve your particular shop. I think going the arsonist route could work.
I've liked the idea of wearing burning armor, which is just normal armor which I've strapped burning logs to.
Just kind of a running and continuous scream as you're going anywhere.
At a cupcake.
Excellent. Primal Moose has asked. He's great. Where are these people from?
Canada,
so I think this might be to you, my Jesus, my darling Jesus. It was good that you said you would look at making slowest instances free, but that still doesn't quite bring the situation in line with how it was before. In a slowest spawn, you're still well behind the world spawn rate. Is there a reason you're reluctant to let the standard spawn instances be free?
So I don't think it's necessarily a reluctance, as more of a time investment in... It's less about the kind of speed of the instance and... we need to take into consideration the wealth of the instance as well. There's things to look at there. But
and Mod Ramen has been...
Mod Ramen.
To name check him, because I name check him in every stream, because I love him.
We love Mod Ramen.
We love Rod Marmon.
Yeah, Rod Marmon. It's all about Rod Marmon.
Well, that's his name forever.
Yeah.
Oh, Rod.
It is Roderick Marmon.
Roderick Marmon. New character coming to RuneScape.
Roderick
of House Marmon.
So I've tried to break up the questions, so I'm fiddling around with the format. Next, I would like to check in with Elite Mobs. This is your team again, isn't it?
Yes.
What you're moving on to after Waterfall Fishing.
That's right.
Obviously another Rune Labs idea, because you love the Rune Labs. You've got so
many ideas. We have all the Rune Labs ideas.
We've got concepts. So would you please talk over the concepts?
Okay.
So what's the first one?
What do we have first?
Camels. Yes.
As Cyrus in the chat will obviously say, you know, was one of the suggestions. And these are camel warriors. They are minions of Akthanakos. I can never pronounce his
name. That's
good.
Right.
Yep.
And they are not just warriors, but they're also intelligent conversationalists. The current
hat on hump
these
optional?
Is to
not well, optional
love that
for defence.
Brilliant. The pipe will probably go.
I'm not sure, but yes,
but yeah, we these are gonna
Well, that's going to be the new pipe slot.
The new pipe slot.
Pipe slot. Oh, God, slot. No. Oh man.
That's where fire making's going.
Yeah. The plan is for these to use ancient magics and to have kind of slightly unique combat mechanics. The current theory is they're going to sort of split apart into three different warriors.
We're talking mirage mechanics.
Yeah, we're talking mirage mechanics and all sorts of things. We've got stuff in place at the moment in horrific placeholder version that we're not going to show you.
Yeah.
But it's starting to come along.
Yeah, don't worry, guys. There will be a live stream on this in particular in the future. But this is just to get you interested in our concept. So let's move on to the next one.
The Ripper Demons,
yes.
Oh, I love these. We had Ripper Demons in One Piercing Note. Or rather, there was someone someone disguised as a Ripper Demon.
Yeah, people gave me a lot of flack about that. It's sort of like,
really?
Yeah.
Oh dear. It's been 5 years.
Yeah.
It's probably time.
It's fine.
So you can look at this beautiful, murderous psychopath monster.
You would have thought she cut her nails.
Mm. Nah. And this thing, so we're currently looking at this sort of blood frenzy mechanics, which is the lower health, so you can encourage people to sort of heal more.
Yeah.
The lower health you're at, the more likely you are to be slaughtered because they will sniff it out and they'll come and find you and hunt you down.
Blood.
They'll hunt you over longer ranges. They'll prioritize the person with the lowest health in the area and just dogpile them.
Yeah, that's really nice. I remember doing the brainstorms for this. We're talking like, you know, Vega from Street Fighter crawling up the walls and things like that.
That isn't happening. No. Before anyone asks, that isn't happening.
No.
But we have lots of other cool stuff with them.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay, on to the next one. Hello, Wyvern.
Living Wyverns, yeah.
So these are living Wyverns. As you can see, we've gone for because the plan was for it to be in the Asgardian Ice Dungeon,
yes,
I believe.
Yes,
that was my suggestion.
So it's got a nice neck beard.
Yeah, so it's got a little bit of fur and cool colour scheme. And we're looking at using poison and cold mechanics to be a bit different. Players are going to have to keep kind of their how cold they are balanced, because there's going to be a whole thing of taking more damage from poison if you've not got a cold effect, but taking more damage from physical damage.
Yeah, it's almost balancing a bar.
So you've got to balance
to keep this.
These mobs are things you're going to have to pay attention to.
Yeah.
They're not going to be.
I like to imagine that you have to climb up that mountain to fight it.
That isn't currently planned.
Well, climbing skill confirmed.
I just imagine Gandalf and a Balrog in the back fighting up the mountain.
And the next one.
My favourite.
Our favourite.
Yeah. There we go.
These are the woolly mammoths. We've gone for a bit of a... Because these are from Acheron, where the penguins live, as you can tell by the one on the right. So the left one is the normal one. We've gone for a kind of more noble species. These aren't just sort of dumb beasts. These are intelligent, and they are noble warriors, and they've made the armour themselves. And when you fight them, you challenge them to a gentleman's duel. And then we've got on the right the elite version. Well, they've got a monocle.
I'm so glad my monocle managed to make it from the brainstorm.
The
one on the right is the elite version, and spoiler, it may not end up being anything like this. We're not convinced we can do our current plan, which is to include the penguins on the back.
It's firing
arrows left, right and centre.
This is almost like concept art from the gritty remake of Barbar.
In a world where mammoths have to survive.
Great, I think that looks grand. That looks superb. So there we go, a little window into the mobs. There'll be more later.
Yes,
indeed, in another live stream. So now we hit a little ninja section. Cool. So I'm looking at you. It's not quite time for Timbo Time. We're getting there. You can take longer with these ones.
Okay, I can.
Crumpled Star.
Calm down.
Wants to ask, can the Heffin Agility Course daily challenges be more common an advanced barbarian gnome course at high 90 plus agility levels, as it gives significantly better XP? So I think the question is, can I have more XP?
The answer to that is always no. The answer to that question in particular, the problem with Heffin is that it requires 77, so the challenges are level 77.
Yeah.
So you always get a challenge that's around your level.
Oh, I see. So as you level up, you're going to get something more suitable, which means you're going beyond 77.
So because the advanced gnome and the advanced barbarian have a higher level requirement, you're always going to get those at high levels.
Gotcha.
We can maybe look at maybe adding a threshold to Heffin challenges, but I'm not sure.
Have you got a Timbo pad?
I don't. Should I get my phone?
No, it's fine. It's fine.
Get my phone out.
And Zyke Z, can you make Golden War Priest barrows reobtainable after being destroyed or lost?
No.
Okay, there we go.
They are very special. They are one of a kind.
Yes.
If you want more, you should enter the raffle.
Okay.
Plug.
Yeah. brutal answer. So a few more meaty questions. Here comes the meat. Mm-hmm. Do you have any plans on making ecto tokens useful? That's from pure TPPC.
Maybe. We've. I was discussing with Timbo earlier actually about some stuff for the upcoming Halloween event. There might be some ways that we can get some sort of post-event stuff into the
You might have an ecto theme in there.
Yeah, it's not confirmed yet. Yep. It's just a thought, but we are thinking about it. So probably we'll have some ecto stuff at some point.
Do stay tuned because there may be some little chats about the Halloween event. We've got something to show. Okay. Oh, in fact, one of the general questions from Alex is Alex Dude 3. Spend any secrets for the Halloween special event this year?
In a bit, yes.
Yes. Good plan. Archdragon 414, are we ever going to have another meeting history quest? But kind of Seren quest almost was.
Yeah, sorry.
Sorry, Seren quest within the...
Yeah, we discussed this.
Light within.
I'm personally, I hate time travel. I mean, I know that's ironic given that we used it in the Seren quest recently, but it just...
We've got bugbears we keep talking about, don't we? Amnesia. Like, people amnesia, coming back from the dead.
Yeah. Time travel, it's just... Yeah.
It's like a bad Doctor Who episode.
It's all in one episode, generally.
Oh, we need K9 now. There you go.
Robot dogs. That's not on our list.
I said we need... Fair. Well, we could have a little K9 in here. Puppet. Little puppet mascot.
Just before we went on air, we were talking about having puppets on the live stream, which I'm sure would get a massive appreciation from no one. SCP-121, are there any plans to make thieving less painful for lower levels? I think they're looking at Elf City here.
No?
Wait, they considered Elf City thieving to be low level?
No. So, like thieving in Elf City, but for low levels.
Oh, right.
As a thief, can I steal entry to Elf City, is that what he's asking?
Yeah. In the back pocket of King Lathis, come on.
There's no plans to. I mean, if it is a problem, well, it is a problem. But like, if we get time, maybe.
Yeah.
There's no plans to right now.
No plans to. Okay.
No one likes being beaten up by farmers.
No, but
there's stuff like the cheeky monkey. If you got that,
yeah. There's a few things to help. You can start the Pyramid Plunder at level 31. Question mark.
Yes. So this is how a lot of people train up.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
So. There are a couple of mini games that give you thieving experience.
Yeah, the highest abundance experience and stuff. So
yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Just quickly, chat is mentioning Bloom. Problems with Bloom. Yes, there was an unfortunate issue with the latest engine that was pushed out. It's not actually Bloom that's the problem, it's anti-aliasing. If you switch your anti-aliasing off, you should be able to run the game with Bloom.
So is that how we're leaving it?
Yeah. Okay. Everyone turns into a twinkly vampire if you have anti-aliasing and Bloom turned on in DX mode.
Yeah.
So OpenGL will be fine. Turning off anti-aliasing works, turning off Bloom works. There is a fix. It is coming. I don't know when. I'm not engine.
Else we've enabled Twilight Mode.
I like the RuneScape before Vampire Quest.
Make the most of Twilight Mode.
Oh, God.
As a little hint of the tone, the mood you're going to get from Lord of Vampirium.
Sexy. Yeah.
Lots of werewolves with their nipples out, basically.
Yeah. Wow. You said the N-word, not me.
Are we not allowed? Quick, is there a watershed?
Quickly, cut to the puppet show.
We're just now going to see how many times you can say that word. Is that what's happening?
Okay, Zyke Z, for Mod Wilson.
Yep.
Nobody else. I do not want anybody else to talk. Can you introduce the history of hill giants into the quest list?
Maybe at some time, if they'll let me. I mean, I've got a bunch of other pirate-themed quests I'd like to get done, but, you know.
Can hill giants fit into that?
If they let me.
Yes.
David's here.
Yeah.
He but is the man.
If you were in an ideal world, your priority would be a pirate quest.
Would be pirate quest, but if there's a Rune Lab suggestion for hill giant quest and it comes across our desk as most Rune Lab stuff seems to be doing at the moment, then yeah, no worries.
But you dropped in a little pirate reference in Death of V, didn't you?
Yes.
Yes. Well, not Death of V. Again, I'm using our terms.
Yeah, yeah.
Strangely enough, we didn't call it Death of V on launch.
Yes.
Spoilers. If you haven't completed.
Yeah, that one's a little Heroes Welcome. Yeah, that one's a little bit more modern.
We'll bleep that out in edit.
I remember us mentioning the quest in a stream before it came out, and all that I knew about it was internally was Death of V.
I am so fired.
Mustn't call it that.
Is anything else being released next week? I was like, yes, it's
the
A quest?
A quest about Fremenic stuff.
Fremenic, yeah, man. We need to work on our working titles, I feel. Yeah. Not call things by the massive spoiler in it.
Yes.
Oh, the Sleeping Dog was pretty good.
Sleeping Dog, yeah. And Purple Rose.
Yeah.
Those were our working titles for World Wakes, and Fate of the Gods.
Fate of the Gods, yeah.
Got a Gobi question. Hexmaniac, can the Gobi burial charms be given another use once you reach the reputation cap on Mazcab?
I believe Moddeg is planning on adding a techie trade-in for them.
Is that with the Gobi quest?
Yeah, so yeah, there'll be
a provisionally called Rite of Passage.
Oh, he had to say it!
Oh, he said it.
Quick! To the puppet show!
No, it's not. We were just talking about there are themes. Yep. But that are similar, but...
But there's no plans to add a techie for the other guy? What's the other guy? Limestone, Trinks.
Trinks, yes.
Yeah, there's no plans to add techie for Trinks. No.
Marvellous, okay.
Moddeg was very specific about that.
So, right. I feel like we need to go to...
the Rite of Passage.
I'm going to swiftly move past that without talking about it anymore.
Panic sell everything.
I like how my iPad keeps timing out while we're talking, so I'm desperately keying in my code. So maybe it has key loggers. You got into this. But what I'd like to try, Mod Orange Jesus.
Okay.
Mod Jesus.
Okay.
Whenever you're on, the feed often talks about silence Mod Jesus is speaking. So I don't know if that's been happening today. I'd like to try something out. We're going to get you talking about the Halloween content for about 60 seconds or so. Yeah. And we'll see if the entire Twitch feed can be silent for the time that Mod Avatar talks.
If someone talks,
so we just stop.
And we all go home.
Just give no more Halloween stuff.
Well, there is a delay, that's the problem. Yeah. There's like a 20 second delay.
It'll be like the cliff on Twitch Plays Pokemon. If anybody talks, we're going to fall off, we're going to start again, we're going to keep on going.
No, just go silent and just sit there for the rest of the minute, just going,
nope.
Okay, so, Mod Avatar, I don't know why I've done this as a section. This is weird.
This is quiet Mod Jesus talking.
Quiet Mod Jesus is talking.
We should have a little theme for it as well.
Okay.
And a puppet.
So here's the image, go.
Okay, so this is the boss that you'll be fighting in the Halloween event. So we've spoken about it previously. This is Amaskit's avatar. So what you see here is the gateway at the top of the bridge over the river Nomenon.
Nomenon. Okay.
So this is going to be the gate that's at the top. So what we've got at the moment is Ictlarin will be standing at the top of the bridge, and he's kind of like holding the gate shut. To stop the avatar from coming out, and we've got some cool stuff in the event where players will be going around collecting souls, and then you'll get your souls together and you'll kind of escort them up the bridge.
Awesome.
And give them to Ictlarin for safekeeping.
Yeah.
And once kind of enough souls have been amassed and Ictlarin's like, right, okay, it's ready to take them to the afterlife, he stops protecting the gates, fling open, the avatar comes out, and there's a big kind of epic fight at the top. Anyone that's worried about sort of, you know, this being a big combat thing, we're aiming for this to be similar to Claudia. So it's a big epic
scales
thing, a big cool thing that happens.
Yeah.
At sort of set intervals through the event that everyone can get involved in.
Yeah.
And it'll be like a nice spectacle.
Superb. Yeah. So we're also going to do a live stream later on. Purely on Halloween? Well, sorry,
yes.
Not purely. Because I keep on injecting things into the waterfall.
With Halloween.
Yeah, exactly.
And also not later on. It'll be enough a couple of weeks.
We're
not going to casually do a live stream at 6 o'clock.
Yeah, we're just going to keep
now
going.
Now it's Halloween time.
So we are going to do a live stream at 8 game time today, strangely enough. We're going to be doing the
nice
drop.
Nice segue.
Yeah. Thanks. Smooth.
I will repeat that later on, don't worry.
When later on? When during the
end of a couple of weeks' time?
Oh, so bad at this. So the feed, you did okay.
No,
you know.
They didn't.
So
they really didn't.
You had to click your fingers and turn on subscriber mode.
Yes.
You just kind of went...
It happened.
Jesus, it happened. Yeah. You saw it was good. Yeah, so that's a little kind of view into it.
There'll be some more stuff on it at a later date.
And of course, that's really
spoil
early days
too much
of
it.
That model as well.
Yes.
It's
worth noting. It's currently being animated. There's no textures on it at the moment. That is the untextured model. So that's it's looking really cool for the lowest quality that that model will look.
So your model avatar, and you've just shown us an avatar. You've crowbarred yourself in.
It's Avatarception.
Is it going to have a beard?
Why not?
Excellent.
We'll get some beards.
Yeah, who would just shoehorn stuff like that in, eh?
Who would ever do such a thing?
Any of what you who have chased ravens in Elf City will know exactly what we're talking about.
Yeah, anyone who found the raven fishing rod, which nobody seems to have so far.
Okay, so I would like to return to the straw poll. So obviously at the start of this live stream, we mentioned that we wanted to know what your favourite golden items would be for the next raffle. Mm-hmm. We've picked our favourites, and these are what you've come up with. Now we want you to vote on them. Tell us what you would like most as golden items for the next raffle. So we're going to put that up now, and I'll come back to that in a moment. So there's some crackers there. Golden Torva.
Golden crackers?
There. Golden crackers. Done those before.
Yeah, we definitely have. Bronze armour, seismic wand, royal crossbow and armour. And obviously, the obligatory indifferent.
Obligatory golden indifference.
Golden indifference. Oh my.
The indifference set.
It's just a title, The Indifferent, and it's gold.
We need to put that in game immediately. Apart from the fact that I've said we were going to put fewer titles in game. all right, so now it's the bit that you all love. We haven't got Kelpie Cam, but instead we have Timbo time.
Oh, God.
It is Timbo time. So you have the floor, Timbo.
The floor?
You've got the floor. This is your time.
My time.
Are you ready?
What about you?
I'm ready.
It's going to be quick.
We have countdown music.
In Herbal Habitat, can you remove the chat box that pops up when finding a seed in a trap?
No, yeah?
Probably. Yes.
Brilliant. Also in Herbal Habitat, can you allow the use of seed aside while hunting?
Maybe.
Find a friend.
Maybe.
50-50.
Can you add a right-click option to box net and Muramasaur? I hate you, Mod Raven. Traps to reset the trap when they fail, rather than having to dismantle then reassemble the traps every time.
Yes.
Brilliant. Can you make it so the left click option on Chin Chompers and Skill Chompers isn't automatically attack?
Maybe.
This is very satisfying. Can the Tyrannan properly metal, requiring a reward run of clearing 15 plus waves in Rush of Blood be changed to allow trial runs too?
No.
Please remove the chat box that shows up every time you catch a butterfly in Giant Chin Chomper D&D.
Yes.
Excellent, write that down. Will we ever be able to swap Golden War Priest and Barrows with other players for other Golden War Priest Barrows parts?
No, blame Mod Kelpie.
Can the Dragon Claw special attack be added to Chaotic Claws but maybe only 5% stronger to keep it balanced?
No.
Can the option that turns off receiving Prawn Balls also prevent players from using crackers on us?
Maybe.
Can you make Metal Dragons a Slayer task so you can choose what Metal Dragon you want to kill? Now it's 6 tasks you could be assigned.
No.
There we go.
Yes.
You got through. How many yeses were there? Were there yeses?
There was a couple of yeses. I think Kelpie would be proud.
Your specialist subject was Herb Lore Habitat, and you scored. Yeah.
There was no Kelpie raised eyebrow. That's what I was hoping
tweet
for.
Tweet Mod Kelpie.
Tweet Mod Kelpie, yeah. If you want to exchange Barrows outfits.
Okay, so we got... So just to check in on the straw poll, just see how it's going. We're looking at... Oh, so here, this is testing my eyesight. Golden Seismic Wand is top with 35% of the votes. Is that surprising, do you think?
A golden Tinky Barry would look cool.
Yeah, that would be pretty good.
And I'm not sure about giving away level 90 gear.
Just a golden singularity that spews coins.
Just spews particles. Mod Manti would love me forever.
Everybody gets lag.
Spews particles which turn into gold when they hit the ground.
Yeah. Gone bronze armour. Lovely. Is a second with 21%. That's a surprise.
Is that classic bronze armour or is that the new bronze armour?
Obviously there'd be a
both.
Of course. Well, Doctor upstairs is fringing.
Or one would be available on the shop.
Revolving in his golden grave.
Do you want golden bronze armour or do you want yellow plasticine armour?
Is that what it would be?
Yeah.
Well, it would just be the old, it would just look like the old gilded, because the old gilded looked like every metal type apart from dragon. So
Right, so strangely enough, we've rattled through this. So I'm going to grab some stuff from the feed. Will waterfall fishing be added to the daily challenges?
That's a question for these guys.
That's a cracking question. Mm.
Possibly. I mean, it's incredibly high. It's very high level. It's very AFKable. So it would probably not be as challenging.
Well, I mean, ivy and stones. Stones
yeah.
are.
Okay. Yeah. Well, in which case it could be.
Yeah, I think it's a really good question. Thank you, Frank.
Yeah.
It's 2017.
Of course, it's Frank.
There we go.
Two. Yeah.
Jagex Raven. Again, this is specifically you, so nobody else talk. Okay. Will the crystal fishing rod help with golden rocks?
Well, technically, yes.
What, in the, if you fish with it,
you get a better fishing rate. So.
Yeah.
Are there golden fish rocks?
No, he's talking about the golden statue rocks.
So yeah. Non-fishing rocks, I would imagine. Because I'm pretty sure with the golden shattered heart, there is no fishing.
No,
there's not fishing one to help with the golden ones.
Yeah. But all of the other crystal, the reason the questions come up is because all the other crystal tools have some kind of,
That's because they're associated with the clans.
With things with the box.
This came through as an issue today, but at the moment, no, because there's no fishing.
Could maybe increase the shattered heart rocks.
Yeah. All right.
Maybe.
Will you rework the instance costs for Iron Men?
Ask Rod Marmon.
Yes. One of the things that I really want to do as lead designer is get better Iron Man guidelines for us.
Yeah.
I think get a better understanding what we should or shouldn't be doing for any update with Iron Man. I think we're working a little bit more ad hoc, so I think that would be really valuable. That's something I'm going to be working on soon. Epic Rage. Oh dear. Is it possible to swap Seren Clan symbols with other players?
No.
No.
It's literally not possible. That is the answer to that question. Yeah. It is currently literally not possible to trade.
Not even figuratively. Literally impossible.
Yeah. Okay. I don't think we should add the... I don't think we should.
Sure. Another Elf City Waterfall question. Do the fishing spots move?
They don't move, but they do turn off briefly just to kind of break up the fishing thing. So it's not 100%. You go up there, you
sort of like Seren Stone occasionally.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. They'll turn off like that.
Never interact with the game again.
Yes. So yeah, it's literally it's very occasional. They don't move. So you can keep standing on. If you saw the little jetties, you can just keep standing on those and just just keep checking back to make sure that it hasn't gone.
Grand. Will urns work with waterfall fishing? Because there is a product.
I hope so.
Yeah. Yep. They should do. Yeah.
Pretty sure they work. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, we'll check, but that's another great question.
If they don't, that's something for cover.
I think we need to employ lots of these people as testers. They're grand. Raven and Timbo. Can you look at adding the journals from The Light Within post-quest to the POH bookcase? Same with Heroes Welcome.
We can look at it. It's not going to be anything we'll get to really quickly because my time is on.
It's like one of those kind of game-breaking
things. But it's something that we could do. Yeah.
The Heroes Welcome one should be added on there. I remember getting issues through to add them to it. So
that's something you've changed post?
No. It was their pre-launch.
Okay.
It should be.
So do let us know if that isn't happening for you. We'd love to know.
As regards to ninjas, we like to do things in batches like that.
Yeah.
It's not worth it for one at a time. Yeah. Mm. So if there's any other books that should be added, let us know and we might do a big batch of ninja stuff.
Sweet. Can you update the gem bag to allow it to store lower level gems, opal, jade and topaz?
Who is collecting that in huge quantities? That's what I ask. That's what I ask in response.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And are there enough people there to warrant it? Who do that to warrant it?
You should
it?
Be dropping them.
Oh, really?
Not worth it.
There you go, a little tip.
Some honest truth from Martimbo.
Okay. Krondis or Crocky God, can we get the ability to pull the quest list out to the main game screen the same way as the inventory, equipment, skills, etc.? So that's kind of child interface, I think.
Oh, yeah.
It's one of those things. The quest list is something we really want to improve.
Yeah,
I think we've looked at that so often. It's not up to the standard of the other interfaces, in my opinion. And there's so many things you could do.
There's stuff we'd like to do with the quest
better
list.
Better filtering, just better pointing to the certain quest.
Having the time to do it, really.
I think players just miss having it there in the bottom right side, like it used to be in the old interface.
Yeah.
Instead of it being a giant prayer interface.
Yeah. So maybe we should say.
It's the classic answer of legacy reasons, but I mean with the quests it really is the current quest log isn't really one quest log, it's several kind of bolted together that represent quests in different ways depending on when they were made and what system they were made with. And
it's back to spaghetti code again, isn't it?
It's not necessarily the spaghetti code.
It's multiple systems
on top of each other, and so.
And of course, it's like every single quest that uses that in a slightly different way would have to be checked or.
Yeah, but we would love to. Really passionate about that. Why is there no Guthix emissary, but there is a Bandos and V? That's from The Void 619.
Didn't Guthix want to be forgotten?
Yeah.
Yeah.
He didn't want followers.
But then again, neither did Sliskane. As a counterpoint.
Does.
No, but yes,
he does. Gothic says he doesn't want followers and means it. Sliska goes, I don't want any followers.
And Rilomio is like the ultimate fangirl as well.
Yeah.
That's awesome. That's such a great point from...
I quite like Rilomio
quest. Yeah, Missing Presumed Death.
Missing Presumed Death, which
she
on a
stood
rock.
Outside going, notice me, senpai, notice me.
She needs her own quest line. That's fantastic.
Rilomio is great.
Surely the player is basically Gothic's cemetery.
Good point.
Nice. I like that.
Which is why you're going to team up with the hill.
It's official now.
Which is why you're going to team up with the hill giants on a quest where you stand perfectly still with a signpost and waiting for a whole bunch of people to come running over to you.
Equal rights for trolls.
Yeah.
I really want you to do a Screaming at Cupcakes quest, by Tony. I think the person who did Let Them Eat Pie.
Screaming at Cupcakes? Yeah, it's sort of like Eli Bacon has moved into now baking, and you're just sort of like looking at his cupcakes and screaming. Santi check.
I was thinking it could be the next Pirate Quest like cutscene, where you're like kittens playing with. You'd love someone just screaming at cupcakes.
We've got more waterfall fishing questions. Yep. Will the Fury Shark outfit work with waterfall fishing? I like that somebody's just going through everything that modifies fishing and it's trying to catch it and doing really well at it.
Basically, it works through the regular fishing system. They're not like unique spots that have their own code. If it goes through fishing, it'll go through this code.
So yeah, the increased chance works, the double fish works.
Yeah.
You can consume them, but you'd be stupid to.
Mm. All right. Well, I'd like to check in one last time to the straw poll. Before we go,
not much has changed.
We still have the wand at the top.
Well, let's act surprised.
Everyone would like a free golden 90 wand.
Yeah.
What a surprise.
Nobody went for my golden tea.
Let's look at it again and pretend that bronze is winning, so we'll be surprised this time around.
we'll cut that out, it's fine.
Yeah.
Okay. We'll make the final project.
We'll in post, we'll edit it in. Pop it.
Yeah. So hopefully you enjoyed the stream and you're looking forward to Elf City Waterfall Fishing coming out on the 21st. As previously mentioned, and also Elite Mobs, which we had a little kind of look at the concept art and Halloween. Mm-hmm. We've got a community stream later on today, 8 game time. See Mod JD, Mod Nina doing the drop, so see how they do there. And thank you very much for watching the stream. Hopefully we've entertained you. And I won't be doing this ever again, unfortunately. But it's been fun.
That's a lie.
Yeah.
You've got a taste right now.
Yeah, that's it. Look, I'm in the
You're going to be doing your own podcast. So like sneak in here at night.
He's just going to crash the stream randomly. Yeah. He's going to be like, he's going to be watching at his desk and be like, nope, I need to be there.
I'll be behind the sofa occasionally, just grabbing people.
You're going to be the puppet. You're going to pop up in case
it's like. So it's been lovely talking to you guys. And